God, you're great.
Thanks, Jez. You're great too.
Sometimes I'd like to die and climb inside you.
Okay.
Was that too much? No. Go on, ask her.
Nancy, I was wondering whether you consider being maybe my proper, you know, just you and me girlfriend.
Wow, I don't know, I mean, that's really nice, Jeremy, but...
There's always a but.
Well, I mean, we're so different. I've got my religion, my yoga size, my charity stuff. I just don't know where you'd fit in as a boyfriend.
But I really like you, and we have a great time together.
Well, I really like you too, and we do have a good time together, but...
That's the second but.
What about all the other stuff?
Other stuff?
Look, obviously God wanted us to enjoy ourselves. I mean, that's why he invented pills and clubs and lube and hardcore. But he also wanted us to give something back. And that's why he created the homeless, the lepers, and the oil spills.
God. Suck up to God.
Nancy, listen. The only reason that I don't go to church is that, for me, everything's a church. This room is my church. The hall is my church. Cost Cutters is a bloody cathedral.
That's really nice, Jeremy. It's just not true, is it?
End of quarter sales push. Pulling an all-nighter. One of the few in my Spitfire. Who am I kidding? I probably would have crashed my training plane during the phony war. Uh-oh. Bollocks. Giggling. Sharing. Shall I intervene? No. It's fine. It's totally fine. Que sera, sera. Whatever will be, will be. The future's not ours to see. If she fucks him, I'll kill myself.
All right there, mate.
Hi.
Hobnobs. Thought you might like some, mate. You know, pulling an all-nighter, we're all in it together, aren't we, mate?
Right.
Hope this works.
Well, that's nice. Do you want to come in?
Mate, the magic code word. Instant rapport with taxi drivers, builders and garage men.
Blimey, mate. Look at all these TVs. You can see it all from in here, can't you?
Yep. So, what's your name, pal?
Pal? Is he a pal person?
Mark, pal.
Ah, Terry. Mark here's brought us some biscuits.
Cheers, mate.
Now we're back to mate. This is a nightmare.
No problem, mate, pal. So, I bet I can see my mates from up here, yeah? Oh, yeah, look, there they are, laughing away like a pair of bloody idiots at absolutely nothing.
Your mate's getting fresh, is he?
Oh, God. Oh, God, no.
Hey, Till, get me a tape.
Don't tape it. Stop it. Charge up your tasers.
Oh, look at that.
That is hilarious.
I'll tell you what, he can give her one from me.
And me.
Brilliant.
God, I'm good. It's a Saturday night and I'm doing good. Come on, give us a smile. You don't know I'm here with an ulterior motive.
Jeremy!
Nancy!
Since when were you involved with street work?
Since forever. Bloody hell, this is amazing. I had no idea you were into this stuff too.
Really? I'm pretty sure I mentioned it.
No, I don't think you did. Because if you had, I'd have mentioned it too.
Right.
Yeah, I love hobos. Always have, always will. And they're a great bunch down here, the Jesus Cave crew.
Yeah. Although, don't you think sometimes they can be a bit patronizing? It's like, sorry we're all out of soup and bread, but oh look, this is lucky. We have lots and lots of wine and tiny little wafers.
Yeah, that is so whack. I mean, Jesus fed a multitude of followers with just 5 loaves and 2 fishes. Matthew chapter 14.
Nancy!
See you later, honey.
Later, baby.
I'll probably get to bone her later. Cheer up, Beardy. Everything's coming up roses.
Another cup of tea? Girlfriend?
I'm good, thanks. Boyfriend?
Ah, this is the worst bit. I hate this bit. This is the worst bit.
Come on, mate. There's no point torturing yourself.
It's not torture, it's research. Besides, I've got a right to torture myself if I want to. What are you gonna do? Call amnesty? See, that! That's the push! She can't get away, he's some sort of animal. Did you see the push, Jeremy?
Yeah, sure, that looked terrible.
Looks like a one-off, though, doesn't it? A crazy flash in the pan, don't you think? I mean, Nancy, you're her friend. Give me your analysis. I mean, did she tell you what happened after?
Well, apparently, he took her to the bathroom for a little bit of... But Sophie was totally not into it.
Oh.
So they went back to his place, they made out for hours, and she jerked him off.
Oh.
But then he went away and he hasn't called, and she's really pissed off about it.
Oh. Brilliant.
And our ambition should be to kill clients. I mean, actually kill them with our levels of service. So they're dead.
She's not gonna smile, Jeff. Not now. You can't laugh at someone you don't trust. It's like Mum singing the Lumberjack song after she had her affair.
So, Aberdeen. I need a couple of experienced credit managers up there for 10 days on-site personnel training. I was thinking, Sophie and Jeff.
No, no, no! 10 days? He can wheedle his way back in 10 days.
So, unless anyone else has any thoughts, let's wrap up and have a couple of frappuccinos.
Yes, I have a thought.
Uh-huh.
I very much don't think it's a good idea.
Oh, okay. Why's that?
It's just a hunch, okay? And I always trust my hunches.
Thanks, Columbo.
And plus, Jeff doesn't have much experience. The 2003 Scottish Consumer Directive, for example.
I really don't think that affects us, Alan.
Oh, it doesn't affect us that during the first phone contact we're obliged to set out without abbreviation the terms of a standard repayment plan.
I've shot you, Jeff. With a bullet made of Scottish finance regulations.
So, Mark, would you be prepared to go up there with Sophie if that's the way things panned out?
Yeah, Alan. I suppose I could probably make that.
Even if I have to cut off all my limbs and crawl to Aberdeen on my tongue.
I can't believe he's wormed his way back in.
Yeah. Well, his mum was really ill, apparently. That's why he didn't call Sophie.
Bastard! Perfect alibi. Still, thanks for the heads up on the date, mate. Great to be able to monitor. And if anyone asks, we're just having a lovely, innocent picnic.
Oops. Looks like he's having a bit of trouble with the Humpty. Keeps rolling on out.
Brilliant. Although, apparently she finds that amusing. They're laughing, Jez. They're having a good time.
Got to stop it. Throw a snack. Hit him on the head. No, get them to film it. Build up a library of taped evidence. Right, evidence that I'm an obsessive voyeur.
Bad news, bad news, bad news. Jesus, Jeremy, one bus crash. What about all the buses that made it safely to their destinations, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, this is such bullshit.
Yes, I suppose the news should just be a dispassionate list of all the events that have occurred the world over during the day. That'd be good. Except, of course, it would take forever.
Firm action to move on nuisance drinkers from the Copthorne
Heath
area.
That's our picnic! You can't see the kettle chips!
Bloody hell!
Whose business is it where you do your drinking?
I wasn't drinking, I was having a picnic! Hello? Mum, we were having a picnic. Tell Dad it was a picnic. You can't see the crisps. We had 3 different flavours of crisps. Explain to him. And scotch eggs. Yeah, no, really, I'm fine. Listen, I've got to go. Cocknobs.
Mark, don't worry. These things, they happen for a reason. It might not seem like there's a plan, but there is a plan.
Oh, right. You believe in a god, do you?
Yes, I do. And you might find it a comfort at
Nancy,
a time like...
Nancy, there's no evidence for God, whereas Ofcom has published guidelines.
So does God. It's called the Bible.
Oh, yes, the Bible. And I wonder what the Bible's view is on you doing it. In the shower and the garden centre and up the bum. I mean, that's all right, is it? That's in the Bible, is it? Or do you think maybe that's not in the Bible?
Mark! I'm sure it is in the Bible. Somewhere. Probably in Corinthians, there's a load of weird shit in there.
Are they staring? They're all staring at the drunk off the news. Yeah, well, fuck them. Me and Sophie are going to Aberdeen. I'll make everything all right in Aberdeen. They're probably not even staring. Just being paranoid as usual. Oh, fuck.
All right. Ha-ha. Very funny. Yeah, I can take a joke as well as anyone else. But if there are any more jokes, I'm taking it to a fucking industrial tribunal, okay?
Mark. Can I have a word?
Let me explain. It was a picnic. I'm currently speaking to Ofcom.
Right.
I mean, we had three flavours of crisps.
Sure.
Good. Well, I'm glad you understand.
Oh, I understand. Totally. Mark, listen. I've been there. I've been to the bottom of the bottle and back to the top.
No, Alan, I...
We're kindred spirits, Mark. Like George W. or Alistair Campbell. We want it all, we want it now. And if we're not hitting our targets, we're hitting the bottle, right?
Alan, I'm not an alcoholic.
Sure. Sure you're not. That's what I told myself every day for 15 years. But until you face your demons and put the plug in the jug, how can I trust you to be my main man in the office, let alone Frankfurt or Aberdeen?
I've got to go to Aberdeen. I've got the rough guide. I could always sell it on eBay. No, I've got to go to Aberdeen with Sophie.
Have you found it yet?
Found what?
The bit. You know, the bit where it says it's okay to do it up the bum.
I'm not looking for that. I'm just reading.
Okay, sorry. Sorry.
Listen, Jez. I want to ask you something. If we can do something very special.
So glad I didn't rub one out in the shower.
I think it's time we break the last taboo.
Brilliant. It's not gonna hurt, is it? What is it? Is it in the ear?
Listen, now we've done it round every which way there is. I'm just wondering if we shouldn't try not doing it.
Not doing it?
Yeah. Wouldn't that be amazing?
No, not amazing. Wrong. Think, brain. Yeah. Or, I tell you what, go the other way. Do a John and Yoko. Never stop doing it or get out of bed until, like, all the injustice in the world is totally sorted.
Jeremy, I really want to give this a go. It's a real deal breaker for me.
Well then, let's give it a go. This isn't anything to do with what Mark said, is it?
No, of course not.
Because you know he's just the ghost at the feast, don't you?
I'm so glad you understand. You're great, Jez.
This is fine. We don't need sex. We can talk. Maybe I can get her to talk dirty while I pull myself off.
Hello. My name's Mark, and I'm an alcoholic. So I'm a lager drinker, mainly. I think I had my first one when I was about 14. Hofmeister. You remember the bear with the pork pie hat? Yeah.
Surely that's enough.
Let it out.
Yeah, so lately, it's got really bad. I've been on the rum and coke.
More?
And vodka and gin, all mixed up. It's not even a proper cocktail, it's just made up. And I just drink that and stay at home. And eat oven chips. Out of the bag, frozen. Until I throw up on myself. That's how pissed I've been. Thanks.
God, they'll believe anything. All you've got to do is turn up and moan.
Thank you, Mark.
What's so great about sex, anyway? It's all in the mind. Her soft skin is just a big bag full of kidneys and mucus and half-digested bits of pie. I bet she's got really nice kidneys.
Oh, yeah, I'd fuck those kidneys real good. She looks fine. Why am I not fine and she's fine? She's probably getting some somewhere. Maybe she's doing it with him.
Excuse me. Is there a suit without meat?
Listen, mate. Beggars can't be choosers, all right? Oh, right. Now they're laughing. But what's so bloody hilarious? Right, that's it. That is the fucking limit.
Hi.
What's so funny? What's the big joke?
Hey, Jez. Shouldn't you be sorting out the queue?
Why? What are you doing that's so important?
Oh, well, I was just helping them fill out some benefit forms. God, they're a real pain. I'm gonna go do the soup.
I know your game. I know what you're up to, Nim.
What?
Oh, sure, yeah, you need help filling your forms in. Oh, please, missus, I've been on the streets for so long, I've forgotten how to use a pen.
She offered and I just said yes.
Like you even need them at all. Oh, my forms, my precious forms. I've got my eye on you, mate. It's fine. There's nothing to worry about. She's not fucking anyone. We're just sitting watching TV. That's bad body language. She hasn't mentioned that homeless guy once. Probably wants me to forget all about him. Oh, that's it. She's off. She's leaving me. Fuck! Where are you going?
Just wanted some more juice. You want some?
Sure. Relax. Play it cool. She loves me. She's not just here because she hasn't got a TV.
Oh. Listen, Jez. I forgot to mention, Nim's gonna be moving into my flat.
What the fuck? Nim? The homeless guy?
Just until he gets his own hostel place. Oh, Jesus, Jez. Nothing's gonna happen. He's homeless, Jez. He sleeps rough every night.
Exactly. He's fine. It's what he does. It's his whole thing. He probably loves it. The rolling hills, the heather. Don't fence him in.
It's only till they sort out his claim.
Look, this is ridiculous. We've got this massive sofa. Nim should stay here. Yeah, it'd be a laugh. I love the homeless. One of my own would be amazing. I could look after him. Not like a Tamagotchi. Better.
I'm fine, Dad. Please. There's no need to come and stay. I know it was on the news, but you know what the news is like these days. They just make it all up. No. Okay, please don't use that voice. All right. See you at the station.
Hello.
Hello. Jez, there's someone I don't know sitting on the sofa eating my Sara Lee.
He's a good friend of mine called Nim who happens to be homeless.
He's not staying here, is he?
Oh, right. I take it you prefer to see him out on the street. You know, brush them away, hose them down, put them into camps. Is that the idea?
No, of course it isn't.
Yes, he's going to stay here, unless you want him to freeze to death, or is that exactly what you want?
No. Look, he must have some benefits or something.
As a matter of fact, he doesn't. Some bloody guy ripped up his forms, apparently.
Why on earth would they do that?
I don't know, Mark. I guess that's just the way life is on the streets.
Listen, Nim, I feel awful. But the thing is, my dad's coming to stay, and he considers Sir David Frost to be something of a hippie. So you're going to have to leave. I'm sorry, I wouldn't normally do this. I mean, I have a standing order to the Royal National Lifeboat Institute. That's the kind of guy I am. Maybe you can take some comfort from that.
God, she's gorgeous. This is killing me. Maybe I can just go and rub myself against her. Say I'm doing an experiment. No, too pathetic. Okay, here goes. The nuclear option. The ultimate. So, Nancy, I just wanted to say how much I'm enjoying not having sex with you.
Really?
Yeah. Come on, Jez. Death or glory. In fact, I was going to propose that we should probably never have sex again. I mean, all that humping and pumping. We could take all of that wasted energy and try and accomplish so many more important things.
Well, yeah, I mean that's great, Jez, but I really wanted this to bring us, you know, closer together.
Oh, but it has. I feel incredibly close to you, without any pressure to be sexual. I mean, they're just a pair of human breasts, for Christ's sakes. Now I can finally appreciate your whole body without any stupid sexual desire.
Well, yeah, I mean, celibacy, that's great, but maybe it's all just a bit of naughty Nancy. Nancy can't have fun. Nancy must be punished. And maybe I should just say, fuck you, Mom.
Oh, yeah, take that, God. Shove this up your toga, you big beardy killjoy.
Hey, where's Nim?
Oh, Nim's gone.
Where?
But he's fine. Mark chucked him out.
Jesus, Jeremy! Poor Nim! Where exactly is Nim?
Oh, Nim! Fucking Nim! Look, if you love Nim so much, why don't you go and find him and screw him?
Okay, fine. I will go and try and find Nim. You know, just to make sure that he's not, like, I don't know, dead or something.
Oh, Nancy, I'm sorry. I didn't mean it. Come back. Oh, please, I'm dying here. Just, you know, touch it. Blow on it. You can use a tea towel.
Sofa, I just wanted to say, if we do end up going up the Highlands together, I not only expect, but will insist on separate rooms, because...
Mark?
Alan. It's not what it looks like. It's only a pint.
Only a pint? It's never only a pint.
I didn't even want it. Sophie bought it for me. I asked for a Coke.
No, you didn't.
You know what I'm hearing, Mark? Poor me. Poor me. Pour me another drink.
No, Alan!
This is bullshit, Mark. And you can forget about the 2 weeks in Aberdeen. Two words. Mini bar.
Caliber. Of course, Caliber. Why didn't I say it was Caliber? Caliber would have made everything all right. Okay, I'm going to Aberdeen. I'm going, Jeff. In a canoe made of your skin, wearing your nuts as earrings. All right, Jeff?
All right, Mark.
So, say, tell you what, Jeff. I had a great shag last night.
Oh, really?
Yeah, with your mum.
What?
Yeah, really doing it, we were.
Mate, I know you're pissed off about me going to Aberdeen with Sophie and everything, but you need to chill, okay? You need to chill right out, otherwise...
Otherwise what? What's gonna happen, you homo?
Mark.
Stolen any good cars lately, Mr. Scouser? Hey, where's your native wit now, eh, Mr. Stupid?
Watch it, mate.
Come on, Jeff, let's get down to it, shall we? Come on, you stupid, stinking chicken fucker. Quack, 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 quack. Oh, those chickens really love it when that big rooster Jeff comes a-calling. Ah! He's bloody broken my beautiful nose! That should be more than enough for personnel to go on, don't you think? Goodbye, Jeff!
What, mate?
Where's the other one? You're not the one I bought the lager for.
Lorry knocks off at 6.
But he was supposed to tape the... me and Jeff in the room. He must have taped it. Oh, shit! Look, mate, pal, you got to do me a favour. Hey, Jeff.
What now, Mark?
Yeah, so, like I was saying, your mum. I had sex with her.
Mark, why are you doing this to yourself?
Yeah, and it was great.
Mark, go home.
Come on, you big pussy.
Look, you've obviously got a lot of serious stuff going on. And I'm not going to make it any worse.
Come on. Dick cheese, piss teeth... fish lips. Come on! Have another crack at me, Jeff! Go on, I'll fight back this time! Hit me, Jeff! It's okay. I'll get him at the bus stop. There's CCTV at the bus stop.
Well, the first series of Peep Show is out now on DVD. To order a copy, call 0870 1234 344 or click onto channel4.com/shop. Next, there are some red cheeks on Father Ted. Or more accurately, on Bishop Brennan.